We are here, ladies. We are here tonight on the show. And tonight on the show, oh my lord. Oh my lord. Both chicken legs and Fernando took that L tonight on the... Oh shit. Both chicken legs and Fernando took that L on the show tonight. And Frankie took the W on the show tonight. Oh my lord. Oh my lord. So look. I'm looking at this game. It was a shootout, especially in that first half. I believe the score at halftime? 21-17 Texans led. And Teddy! The difference, yeah, sure. Towards the end of the game, Texans did take over, you know, with those deep ball touchdowns to, you know, Will Fuller and DeAndre Hopkins. But I thought, you know, until about the fourth quarter, most likely, they were trading. The problem was, Miami was moving the football. The thing was, Miami was getting field goals. Texans were moving the football, and they were finishing drives with touchdowns. Timmy! That was the difference. Both teams, I thought, were successful. Maybe the first three quarters. Then that fourth quarter, Houston just fucking took over, you know, winning 42-23. But I thought the first three quarters, the difference was both teams were moving the football. The difference was Miami was finishing their drives with field goals, and Houston was finishing their drives with touchdowns. But Timmy, When did I say it on the live stream? When it was 35-23, I think I said it. This has been the difference. Miami's getting field goals, Houston's getting touchdowns. But that's what happens when you have Brock Osweiler going up against Deshaun Watson. Deshaun Watson is simply a much talented quarterback. So tell me, Miami ain't that far off. They're not that far off. You look at that team. Danny Amendola, Devontae Parker, Skifsky, the tight end, you know, the running back, Kenyon Drake. They're not that far off. They just need to go get a quarterback. Simple as that. I think Miami is going to have to do what the Rams, Eagles, you know, Texans, Kansas City, all these teams have. Arizona did this year when they got Josh Rosen. The Jets, I think they did it too when they got Sam Darnold. Timmy, I'm looking at this Miami team. They are 4-4. They're most likely going to finish somewhere from 7-9 wins. That's not good enough to get a top 5 pick in this draft. Miami is going to have to trade up in the draft to get a franchise quarterback. Because what they have right now, whether it's Brock Osweiler, Ryan Tannehill, Matt Moore, it's just not good enough. Miami's going to have to go out in the draft. Like I said, they're probably going to finish with somewhere to 7-9 wins. So it's not going to be good enough. You're probably going to have to do what the Rams, the Eagles did, you know, Houston, Kansas City, the Jets. You're going to have to go and trade up and go get a franchise quarterback, and then maybe hopefully the whole team can stay together for about 2 to 3 years, and then maybe can do something, because I think Adam Gase would do a fantastic job if he would get his own quarterback. He's getting the most out of, you know, all of these guys. Brock Osweiler, he's gotten the most, I think, out of Brock Osweiler, at least since his first year with Denver, when he replaced Peyton Manning. He's gotten the best out of Ryan Tannehill. And to me, he got the best out of Matt Ryan. He got the best out of Matt Moore. So if you give him a talented, like Justin Harbor, the kid from Oregon, or Costello, the kid from Stanford, he could really do something. He just needs to get his own quarterback in the draft and develop him. But the team, I like this team. Danny Amendola, Devontae Parker, you know, Kenyon Drake, Siski, how the hell you say the tight end's name? I like this team. They just need to go out and get a franchise quarterback. I'm sorry, Ryan Tannehill, Tenny, is no longer a franchise quarterback. Go get a franchise quarterback. And I think they're fine. They're not that bad. Just need to get a franchise quarterback. All right, Houston, fantastic. They're starting to look like last year. Watson is finally starting to get his legs under him finally, and he is starting to use his legs to make plays. Tonight, you didn't know what the hell he was doing. Every time he dropped back, pressure, oh, he's gonna get sacked. He would step up, shake them off, and you know, start running. Sometimes he would take off and run. Sometimes before he crossed the line of scrimmage, he would throw the football. That's unguardable. That's like in basketball when you have like a, you don't know if he's gonna pull up and shoot the three or if he's gonna drive to the lane and shoot a layup or slam dunk. That is what Watson was last year, and he is starting to once again do that this year. He is starting to become dangerous again, is Watson. Because he was one-dimensional about the first month of the season, just with his arms. But now he's starting to get his legs under him, and he, you know, it's hard. He's starting to become two-dimensional. Now you're back to having to worry. If just because you put pressure on him does not mean you're going to get that sack. Even if you have him, he can slip out of that sack and take off and run for 15 yards. You know, Temi, there's only two quarterbacks in this league that can do what they can do that kind of stuff. Patrick Mahomes and Deshaun Watson. They're the only two quarterbacks that can do that. They're just, it's almost like they're undefendable to me. And then, you know, you got Will Fuller and DeAndre Hopkins, you know. I really like this team. I think they will win the AFC South. I really like them. I like them way better than I like Jacksonville. Jacksonville. Kiss my ass, Jacksonville. You know, we might lose to them, so I shouldn't be talking too much trash. We lost to Jacksonville. Anyways. But I like this team. I really like this Texans team. I think they're going to go all the way, sort of 0-3, but that's because Watson, like I said, had not gotten his legs under him. Now starting to get his legs under him, have won 5 straight games. This team is going to win the South. Timmy! The defense, you know, with the defense this time and the way the NFL is now, the defense is going to give up some points. You're going to have to live with it. If you give up 25 or less, that's probably good enough with this NFL because everybody can score nowadays. There's not such thing as a shutdown defense anymore. So they give up 23 points, whatever, you know. Pretty good, you know, and you have to understand there's no such thing as a shutdown defense. There's no more Ravens shutdown defense or Seattle Seahawks. The goal is probably to give the teams under 25. But anyways, good game. JJ Watt looked fantastic. You know, Tyrann Mathieu with that sack coming from the safety. Good game. Watson looks fantastic. His legs are finally under him. He looks fantastic. That's all I have to say for tonight on that show. I will see you tomorrow for Game 3 of the World Series. And until next time, see you later.